Okay, vertical speed, flaps 5.
WAAS is working for Horizon Air, a regional affiliate of Alaska Airlines, which has been using the WAAS technology for 10 years now.
What's been remarkable about it is it's so seamless and it works in a way that it's in the background, you don't even really know it's there.
When they do know it's there is when WAAS allows for lower minimums on LPV approaches.
The availability of being able to get the aircraft in to have weather minimums in the Pacific Northwest, wintertime, challenging terrain with the lowest possible approach minimums, we get in when our competitors, the other airlines, can't get in because they simply just don't have that low of approach minimums.
Horizon's fleet of aircraft includes 34 WAAS GPS-equipped Bombardier Q400s flying throughout the Pacific Northwest and based at Portland International Airport. In addition to providing valuable alternatives to the legacy ground-based approaches, namely LPV approaches, WAAS capability also allows Horizon dispatchers to save time by not having to declare alternate destinations when pilots fly into airports that have GPS approaches only.
Benefits for an airline to have WAAS, essentially the amount of planning that goes into constructing a dispatch release, a flight plan for a 121 flight, is greatly simplified because the dispatcher, in some cases, if the destination airport has only an RNAV approach available, they don't have to go searching for an IFR alternate.
There's another big benefit as well, precision approach minimums to both sides of some runways.
Makes it literally a no-brainer. Then, of course, having LPV approaches is very beneficial because typically you've got ground infrastructure, ILS, approaching one direction to the airport, and the LPV approach is complementary. It approaches from the other end, and yet you have the same minimums.
Given the edge WAAS gives them, Horizon pilots are some of the best ambassadors for the technology.
For Horizon, it's been great. We get in when the weather's below other people's operational minimums.